There's something going on, a couple of things, or a couple of cases that should have you scared to death. It probably won't, because we have sort of gotten used to this and acquiesced to it. There is an old saying, I wish I could remember it, is not going to be the way I'm putting it, but it would amount to the same thing. Someone, Voltaire perhaps eloquently said, when a whole society or culture has its head up its butt, the man who tells the truth is a traitor. And I think this is the situation that Donald Trump has gotten himself in right now, because you have the whole progressive establishment in a fit of apoplexy over a statement. Now, I just want to read you a couple of things here. Let's start with what Donald Trump said. And this, as best I can tell, I was not at that press conference, but from reports or quotes from it, the transcript, here is what Donald Trump said at the announcement of his running for the nomination. Quote, the U.S. has become a dumping ground for everybody else's problems. When Mexico sends its people, they're not sending their best. They're not sending you. They're sending people that have a lot of problems, and they're bringing those problems with them. They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're bringing rapists and some, I assume, good people. Okay, so here is the thing. He said that people emigrating into the country illegally from Mexico, specifically in this statement, bringing problems with them. They're bringing us drugs. They're bringing crime. They're bringing rapists. Now, he didn't say all. Did he say all? No, not at all. Just touching on a few statistics. This is from the Center for Immigration Control. And he said, according to the Office of Immigration Statistics, government agency, of the 188,382 deportations of illegal aliens, 23% had committed criminal traffic offenses, primarily driving under the influence. The 23% criminal traffic offenders is only part of the overall picture. And according to the Center for Immigration Studies, another 23%, now this is of 190,000 deportees who came from Mexico to this country, were deported. Many of them, as you know, are back. But anyway, let's stick with this. Of the 190,000, 23%, more than 43,000, were convicted of drug offenses. The violent crime category of assault, robbery, sexual assault, and family offenses comes to 12%. Nonviolent crime grouping of larceny, fraud, burglary totaled 7%, and said the list goes on, causing thousands or to millions of dollars in cost per alien to the system. Now, move down here. The Huffington Post, which is a very liberal publication, they say, quote, this year, more than 60% of all federal criminal convictions have been for immigration-related crimes, according to federal data. One more thing. The FBI, if you don't want to believe the Center for Immigration Studies or the Huffington Post or whoever, an FBI crime study shows heavy illegal alien involvement in criminal activity revealed in these statistics. 75% of those on the most wanted criminals list in Los Angeles, Phoenix, and Albuquerque are illegal aliens. One quarter of all inmates in California detention centers are Mexican nationals, as are more than 40% of all inmates in Arizona, 48% in New Mexico. Over 53% of all investigated burglaries reported in California, New Mexico, Nevada, Arizona, and Texas are perpetrated by illegal aliens. Now, how the progressive establishment can stick its head up its butt and try to ignore that, I don't know. But you're not supposed to notice that, because political correctness requires that you buy into their fantasy. That's the essence of political correctness. It is a total fantasy that nobody did anything wrong. You see, they take their vision of an ideal world, a utopian world. That's okay. We all have those ideas, and this is, well, people have done it since the dawn of time. What would it be like, ideally? But they proclaim, okay, that's here now. Since we imagined it, it's here, and you're going to live by it or you're going to suffer. And the suffering gets bigger and bigger right now. They want to annihilate anybody who stands in the way of that. But I don't know how you can throw that huge a tantrum over Trump's statement. You may not like it. But the government of Mexico has the gall to be offended by it? They're so upset that I think the drug cartels couldn't even go out and massacre schoolrooms full of children. They're so upset by this. Oh, it's terrible. You should be scared to death. I tell you, the thought police, they're here. It's one thing I liked about Trump. If you want, you could argue with the statement. This is his opinion. But based on the things, the facts that I just read, you understand how somebody can come to that opinion. And to say that some of these people were criminals, well, it looks like a whole lot more than some in these statistics. Obviously, not everybody. Everybody knows that. That would be a total absurdity. But anyway, this is what's happening right now.